What is up, Bradford Bass family? Welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to take you on a tour of all the upgrades and modifications I've done on my Bass Tracker Classic XL. One of the great things about this boat, you know, and I purchased this boat for $13,000 in 2021, so last year. It comes bare bones, bare minimum, not a lot of features to it. But one of the great things about it is you could really make it your own. As more money comes in and you fish it a little bit, you could really customize it to make it suit your needs. All last winter was done a lot of modifications or upgrades, whatever you want to call it, to the boat. But there are some things that some of you guys have seen, and there's some things that a lot of you guys haven't seen. So that's what we're going to talk about today. That's what I'm going to show you. I'm not going to go through all the boat specs. I've already done that. This is just going to be the stuff I've done to upgrade the boat. So let's get into it. Guys, let's start out with the trailer. I don't have a whole lot of things on the trailer, only three upgrades I've done to that. So let me show you those real quick. The first thing is this step right here. I mounted this step, $27, I believe, on Amazon. This thing's great. It took me about 5 minutes to install it. It's really nice at the boat ramp. I drive a Dodge Durango as my tow vehicle. So when I back the boat down, I actually let the hatch up. So usually what I do is when I walk back behind the vehicle, when the boat's halfway in the water, I step up onto the tongue of the trailer. I put my hand on the hatch of the Durango, step up on this, and then right up into the boat. So this is a very nice addition. Makes me feel a little more secure climbing in and out of the boat at the boat ramp. The other thing is the spare tire. Down there you can see it. I think I got that for $90 on Amazon. Tire, rim, everything mounts right down there underneath the boat. It is tight down there, but it definitely fits. The boat doesn't rub. So if that's a question you may have, no, it does not rub. Then the other thing is on the back of the boat is these boat buckle tie downs. The boat comes with a couple tie downs on the back. They're not that great, so I replace them with these retractable ones. They're real easy to do. You just flip that lever up, unhook it, let it fall, and these stay attached to the trailer. And then once you put it back on the trailer, take it back up there, clip it back onto that. And it's only about 1.5 clicks. And that's it right there. Get it nice and tight, you're good to go. So those are a nice addition as well. All right, so in the motor, I've only done one thing, and that's I added the mercury vessel view right here. There's this little plastic piece on attached to the motor, and I zip tied the module to that. It's kind of hard to see. I know the lighting's not that great. But then it plugs over here into this harness. Real simple, easy install. There's this little groove right here on another plastic plate that I just snap the wire back into. Keeps it tucked out of the way so there's no issues there. The vessel view shows your engine hours, tracks your maintenance schedule, shows you a lot of information about your motor. It can track your fuel usage, which is nice because the Bass Tracker Classic XL doesn't have a fuel gauge. So something that's handy. I think I paid $190 for that on sale. Usually it retails for about $230, $240, I believe. So got a good deal on that. So that's the only thing I've actually done to the motor. I also did add this engine cover to the motor. Not a big fan of this logo right here at the current moment, but it's what it is. So this, I pretty much just put this on here because I keep my boat outside during the fishing season. I keep it covered. But this just helps keep some of the sun wear on the motor cowling and helps protect it a little bit. So not something you have to have, but it's nice. So getting into the back itself, excuse me, I've added a third battery. So I got two trolling motor batteries, and then I got my cranking battery. And I also added, which I said in a previous video, I believe is the most important upgrade on the Bass Tracker Classic XL. Onboard charger is very important in my opinion. I couldn't imagine not having one. I don't understand why these boats do not come with them. They're not that expensive. I got the 3-bank Minn Kota 315D, and it's done well so far, but I do need to check in while that light's flashing. So that's it on the, in the back compartment there. The seats, as you can see here, the seats on the boat. So the boat comes with, it comes with two seats with pedestals. They're really nice seats, nothing wrong with them. The only issue is they're kind of bulky. So I actually got rid of, I mean, I still have them, but I don't use them anymore. We actually, I bought two casting seats, one for the front and one for the back, and new pedestals that are adjustable, and it just gives you a little more room. It just gives you more room to walk around because the boat's not that wide to begin with. So the casting seats, you know, they're a little pricey. I mean, the pedestal and the seat itself, it's a couple hundred bucks a piece combined for each one. So, but it's worth it in my opinion. So got the two new seats. On the boat itself, I added this rub rail. I did this about, I don't know, probably 6 months ago. What this is a furniture corner guard, and you can't see it very well. It blends in, and it just sticks onto the boat. It's real cheap. Got it off Amazon. I think it was, I don't know, maybe 30 bucks, and I wrapped the whole boat with it. It goes all the way around the edge, and it's to help protect against the docks and stuff. It's like a foam material, and it's held up really, really well. I mean, it's not showing any signs of coming off. It sticks really easy. If it gets beat up too bad, you can just pull it off and put a new one on. It's a lot cheaper than installing the more expensive rub rail system. So this worked out really well for me, and I'm very happy with it. As you can see right here, I actually took a good, I don't know if you can see it with the lighting, took a good chunk out of it right there. So if this wasn't on there, when that happened at the dock, that would have been taking that chunk out of my boat. So this right here has made it worth it already. So another thing I did is I added LED lighting throughout the boat. Cost me about $130 for the system. I got two back here, one there, one back here in that corner you can see. I got one over here, a longer one. I got one right here underneath the console. And then I also have a strip here on the inside of the gunnel. And I got one over there as well on the inside of the gunnel, over there. And then I also have one in each of my compartments. So 8 lights total. And it's really nice in the morning time. Gives you some light when you're trying to tie on lures or whatever. And it looks really good. Got the little remote panel mounted here. You can change colors of the lights. You can kind of do whatever colors you want. You got greens, blues, purples, whatever you want to do. So it looks really good at nighttime. It's kind of hard to see here in the day, but I'm happy with it. It was easy install. Right here, I just got it plugged into my cigarette lighter, so I can just shut it off right here if I want. Turn it back on just like that. So that's it on the LED lights. So let's get into the electronics. The boat comes with a little Hook 4X Lowrance. It's not that good. So I upgraded to a Garmin 93 SV UHD with a GT54 transducer right here at the console. And let me show you this real quick on the back of the boat. I mounted this, I don't know if you can see it, I mounted this stern pad right here. This stern pad is like an epoxy. You can get this off Amazon, and it actually sticks to the boat itself, the hull, and then you screw your transducer into that pad. And it just prevents from having to screw a bunch of new holes in the boat, especially if you end up changing transducers all the time or whatever. So just something real easy and quick to install. So getting back to the electronics, so like I said, I got the 93 SV there, and then new this year, and I haven't fully hooked it up yet, is I added the 7-inch, which used to be up at the bow on my boat. I added it here on the side on a ram mount. Excuse me. And it's going to have this WeatherTight Ethernet cable, which will connect from here to my 93. I got to drill a hole through here, run this cable through there, and I got to run a power cable through there. I just haven't got around to it yet. So my plan is to be able to do my imaging on this, probably. At least it's my plan right now, is to do my side imaging right here, down imaging, whatever, and I'll do my mapping on the 73. And then up at the front of the boat, I purchased another Garmin 93 SV here at the bow. And I got the transducer for that right here on the bottom of my trolling motor. So, speaking of a trolling motor, that's probably a good segue into that. So, the boat comes with a Minn Kota Edge, 45-pound thrust, 12-volt. I upgraded the boat to a 55-pound thrust Minn Kota Turova, with iPilot. It's a pricey investment. iPilot with the spot lock was something I felt like I really needed to have. Nothing wrong with the Minn Kota Edge. It came on a boat. It did the job. But it's going to be a lot better, more comfortable fishing this way with the spot lock. And if you can swing it, I say definitely go for it. At least go for some kind of trolling motor upgrade. It'll just make your experience that more comfortable, especially when you're fishing in the wind and such a light boat. So the Minn Kota Trova is probably my favorite upgrade, the most important upgrade I've done to the boat, to be 100% honest with you. Another thing I added was where the wires come out for the trolling motor. I got this little wire gland right here. It's like a little rain housing for the cables to come out to try to keep water from going down inside the hull. Nothing you have to have. Some guys just put the wires back in here, but it's just something I did to try to clean it up a little bit. And I put some corrugated tubing to kind of control the wires. Now you see I got another rim mount here. It's not attached right now. The plan is hopefully it eventually get a live scope. And if I do, this is where I'm going to put it. I'm going to put another unit right here for the live scope, and I'll mount this ram mount somewhere in this vicinity right here. So that's it on the electronics, the trolling motor. Another thing I added was these retractable rod straps. So I added one here, one across on the other side of the front deck, and I also added one on the back right there for the co-angler. These are really nice. These are pricey as well. These run you about $100 a piece almost. You cut them down into the deck of the boat, it's clipped, and they suck back like that. Real simple, clean, and you just clip them back in there. Makes it fast, they're sturdy, holds plenty of rods underneath there. I really like the look of them. All right, guys, so inside the boat, we got the casting deck extension. This is probably the first upgrade I did. Unfortunately, the boat does not come with a very big casting deck, so I added this extension. It's not screwed to the boat. It just lays in there. You got two compartments for it. I don't have no tackle in here right now. I actually got all my tackle out of the boat. As you can see, it's kind of hard to see probably, but the LED lighting is in there. If you can see it right there. So I got a compartment there for my tackle and another compartment right here for my tackle. So two large compartments to add more storage. And I also capped off the end of it, as you can see right here. And forgive me for the light, guys. I know that window's got a bunch of light coming through. I need a damn curtain on the thing. So I covered up the rod holders that come on the boat with that cap. I have a lot more rods than that, so I knew I wasn't going to use them. So I just covered it up. I added a couple tool holders, two Rapala tool holders. I got one mounted right here that holds some snips, that holds my Bluetooth speaker, my hook remover, scale. And then I also added another one right here on the side of the console. It's got some tools in it, and my snips are actually in the house right now. They usually go in right there. I added a cup holder right here, as you can see, hopefully. You can see with the light. I added this cup holder here most recently. To be honest, we rarely put drinks in there. We usually have lures stacked in there. I also added this Rapala retractable ruler. So basically, you just pull it out, measure your fish right there on the deck, and then you push this button right here, and it sucks the ruler back in there. So it's a nice ruler. It seems to do the job. Also added another cup holder right here, a flip cup holder. Originally, I had only these flip cup holders on there, but I've already replaced a couple of them because they bust pretty easily if you kick them or something. So don't really use that, but it's there. Turning around here, my favorite upgrade on the boat, to be honest with you, besides the trolling motor, is this little step glove box I put between the seats. So similar to the casting deck, this glove box just fits right, this step glove box, whatever you want to call it, just sits right between the two seats. And then I've added this box in the middle. And this is where I put my wallet, my phone, stuff like that, that I want to keep dry, because this is a dry storage box. So, and it acts as a step up to the back deck. Then I also got a couple more of these little flip cup holders right here. But like I said, we rarely use them. So, that's that on there. I think that's it, guys, that I could think of. I'm sure there's something else that I'm missing, but I believe that is everything I've added to the boat. So I believe that's it, guys, for the video. I apologize for the not so good lighting. I could have opened the garage door, but that would have just brought more sun rays through. So I think I've showed you everything I have. I'm sure I'm missing something. I put a lot of time, a lot of sweat, a lot of money into this boat, to be 100% honest with you. But I love it. You know, I really do love it. So it's, I love it because it's my first boat. I love it because I've done so much to the boat. So it's really personal to me more than anything. It's not that it's the greatest boat in the world or anything like that, but it's just, it means a lot to me. Just because it's my first one, probably more than anything. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Hit that like button if you would. Subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys soon.